Hello! The more astute among you might notice that we are back in the Arcanist Guild. There's a reason for that. A, we're level 30 Arcanists, and B, we are a level 15 Thaumaturge. Thaumaturge. Whatever, however that's pronounced. Most of this has been done off screen. I haven't done any quests, so I'm keeping the quests on, don't worry about it. I also did some horrible war garble crafting stuff that I'll explain why later. But for now, we have a level 30 guild quest, and I am in a terribly uncomfortable position. But whatever. We need to do this quest. Supposedly, this quest will unlock the way to become a summoner. This is actually the level 25 quest. Also, just realize the game is still muted. Shall we actually remedy that, you imbecile? There. Now the game's not muted. Sigh. So apparently we're gonna have to do two quests back to back out of the guild. I thought I had already done the level 25 guild quest. Apparently I had not. So we need to go to the trading post in Upper Lanasia. Didn't we already do this? Or was that a different thing I was doing at some point? I don't remember. Either way, we need to go to a place that I cannot teleport to. Which sucks. And the nearest teleport is down in Aleport, is it? Yes. So we're gonna just straight up teleport to Aleport, because that's how that works. You can actually see I still have the serving of lentils and chestnut quest. I haven't done any quests. I've done some livestream. And some guild hest. I'll go back through and do... actually, I don't know. I don't think I'll actually do the guild hest. The guild hests are essentially tutorials. So, if you're new to an MMO or new to specific mechanics, you can do the guild hest and they'll explain, you know, how X works or how B works. Those things are way too large. They may actually be to scale from the Final Fantasy VI reference that they've used. They could be to scale. They probably are relatively close to scale, for all I know. It's hard to get a scale from older Final Fantasy games where everything is gigantic and misproportioned. You also notice I have the Behemoth Barding on. This is a CE item, Collector's Edition item, so if you happen to have that. Also, there's a summer event going on. You can see people over here talking about sparklers and stuff. I actually have some sparklers. There they are. I have a few Leminsen sparklers on my inventory here. And you can also get a... well, many. You can get one sparkler... well, I should rephrase that. There's one type of sparkler for each of the main cities, and I don't care about this. And you can also get some summer swimwear, should you desire. There's quite a lot of varieties of that, so... you know. Hook yourself up with that, I guess. A witness! I sure would've just ran into the water, but a witness has shown up. My desk is very squeaky today. Well, squeaky, crackly. It's not really a good word for it either. The way to Thalios. Thalios. Okay, so speak with the Thaler at... the Scholar at Thalios. Now how do I actually get up there? Is it just a straight... run? I keep forgetting how my UI works. I'm probably going to swap the UI up again so it looks a little cooler. We'll see. And I can't run across that, so. I love the chocobo music. It's great. This is actually a decent place for fate grinding. Because the fates are relatively quick and it's a relatively small area, so all of the fates are more or less right next to each other. Is he up here or in that house? Can you go in this house? You can. It turns out he is... is this where I'm supposed to be going? I guess this is where I'm supposed to be going, so we'll talk to this man here. The Arcanist Guildmaster! He bid me pass on a message to anyone who came searching for him. Reunited, the three slips of parchment hold the problem to the solution. What problem? What solution? What parchment? Concealed among the bones of Thalios. Thalios. One of these days I'll pronounce that properly. Probably not anytime soon. There's that fate out there. So... I'm gonna need to go up, am I not? Titan will not suffer you on this mountain. Have fun with that. In the meantime, I have things to explore. And of course there's aggressive creatures here, but hey. That's not a very well hidden parchment. I mean, you just kind of threw it on the ground. It's kind of a cool area. I didn't actually, the first time I came here doing gathering, I didn't actually realize you could come up here. Like amongst the bones, as it were. There's literally giant, like, dragon skeletons? I don't really know what they are. There's the parchment down there. How do I get back up, though? How do I click it? There we go. The bones, man, the bones are in the way. Do I need to go back up, or is it just gonna be, like, over here? Or is this a way back up? This looks like it's a possible way back up, so. No? There's an invisible wall there. I don't know. Curse you, Final Fantasy, and your invisible walls. Is there a way back up? There's not a way back up, is there? I'm a fool. Oh. I should have been a bit more careful about that, I guess. We're just gonna have to jump back off. Can I get... Question becomes, can I get over there? Answer is no, because I plummeted like a rock. Quick, man! Jump for distance, and then plummet like a rock to nothingness. So that's a thing. That's a thing that occurred. I'd also like to know why my desk is squeaking every time I lift my arm. You guys may or may not even be able to hear that. So I have no idea. Anyway, continue. Over here, where something hopefully doesn't try to murder me. Something's gonna try to murder me. I need to summon my pet. I keep forgetting I swapped Arcanist. I've been doing so many other classes that I just keep forgetting about my Arcanist pet. I'm hoping my pet will try to distract him. Pet, distract him. There you go. I don't really want to fight the dude. I just want to get the thing. What is over here, actually? Outer Linosia. Let us quickly investigate real quick. Quickly do things quickly, yes, is how this works. Someone asked something in chat there? I don't know. It's a level 30 area. Is there a... There's one there. And there's a fate. Well, I don't really want to be here, so... At least not right now. We'll probably have to come back here. Whoa, that is a funny looking lizard creature. Probably gonna end up having to come back there for the level 30 quest, knowing me, and I'll wish I had gotten that teleport, but... Whatever. We need to go talk to... Tangatonga. Tonga Tanga Tanga Tonga. That dude has a great name, I'd just like to point that out. You can't go wrong if you call yourself something silly like Tangatonga. Also, you will not die, I got off a bit preemptively, you will not die unless you are in combat from fall damage. It will leave you at 1 health, regardless of how far you fall, so long as you're out of combat. I have tracked down the paper. Both sides are filled with letters and markings unlike any you have seen in Eorzea. So this dude won't turn around, just holds his hand up. A wild dodo chase, We don't like dodo around here. Seek the box at Fool Falls, dance a jig for your wooden audience, claim the secret from the opened heart. Well, where is Fool Falls? Right there. Oh, okay. Convenient. Don't mind if I just call my chocobo into your house, good sir. Should be a little bit more, you know, nice about that whole calling my chocobo into people's houses thing. Where's the... There it is. I was looking for the pathway up here. I'm gonna have to run the long way around, but this will be a quicker way to get over here, I think. Actually, well, maybe not. I could have probably just jumped off right next to the dude's house, but whatever. Oh wait, I don't need to run all the way around. What am I smoking today? And there's a boss fight here. And this looks like a relatively interesting boss fight. boss fate. Whoa, what's going on here? My level is too high. Oh, right, I have to level sync. Moderately confused about what was going on there, and I did this in the wrong order and stood in an AoE like an idiot. Although the AoE appears to not have triggered, so whatever. I have a specific order I need to do my abilities in, which I screwed up. That's an AoE I don't want to stand in. My pet can. I don't really care what my pet does. I should be using my tanking pet for this, but I'm over-leveled anyway, so it'll be right. My pattern is Miasma 2, or sorry, Bio 2, Miasma, Lightning, and then Arrows slash Bio. It doesn't matter what order they go in. And I do this because of the durations of the individual spells. I'm probably going to need to use Aether. Because that's how this works, and apparently I'm just going to tank this thing. So off we go to Tankerville. And Aether Flow will heal me, so. Not Aether Flow, but the ability it unlocks. I also used Raging Strikes earlier, you may have noticed. I've got some abilities that are not actually from this class, and there is a very specific reason for that. I like how I'm still maintaining aggro. Suddenly Coral Pup, for whatever reason. I don't know what that does, but I'm gonna get out of it. As that person casually walks backwards. Oh, it causes slow! Yeah, I want out of that. Slow is bad. Raise, please. Oh, that was Duplo. The almighty Duplo, and of course I aggroed a pup, didn't I? I did aggro a pup. These pups, man, why are they gonna be all up in this? Why didn't they help their mother or whatever? The one that died earlier with like 20 hit points. I think it went very strong. Raging Strikes has a massive cooldown, but I think I just tanked that with my face. But it also causes additional 20% damage, which is quite good. I'm also going to tank this with my face again. I need to be careful with tanking things with my face quite so often. I am over-leveled for this. But that doesn't mean I can tank things with my face willy-nilly like that. And I used those a bit early, but whatever! I can heal myself, so. Although I'm pretty sure I've screwed up my macro for it. My heals are so bad. Oh, someone else has got me healed. It's cool. I don't know how I'm maintaining aggro so well on this thing. That's ridiculous. I mean, I know I'm using damage over time constantly, but man, that's ridiculous. I don't even think this dude gives you anything. Other than experience, but there we go. Ding. That's actually decent experience. 4k? I mean, for the level it is, it's a level 23 one, so. There's an old wooden box here that I must dance in front of. You dance sprightly for the old wooden box. What? The box rattles and thumps about. Okay, is it gonna try to murder me when it comes out? Yes, as it turns out, they are. They are horribly underleveled, though, so it's kind of null and void. Well, I'm horribly overleveled, is what I should say, but I should be using Bio 2 on these things, just because it lasts longer, quite frankly. These things actually hurt quite a lot. I would prefer they'd stop hurting quite so much. That'd be splendid. I'll just keep my two instant cast damage over time on it. Did my pet die? No, it's just casting. That ability, I don't know about that ability. It takes it so long to cast it, but it's the same, like, damage. I got viscous secretions. I already opened the box, now what? Oop, it says open again. Okay, I'm sorry about my desk clicking, I don't know what's up with that. Very clicky desk today. The answers you would seek Then to the trading posts now go, before the owner be not meek. With your 2 feet, provide a show. This is an interesting quest, I must say. My pet's gonna probably aggro to something and I'm gonna lose it at some point on my run over here. I wish once you were above, like, a certain threshold, like, these guys are only level 22. They would still aggro to me. I wish there was a... Yep, there they go. I wish there was a certain threshold where they would just cease aggroing to you automatically. Like, I'm level 30, it's level 22, it shouldn't be aggroing to me when I run by, but... eh. And suddenly fate. I told you this place was good for fate running. If you're level 20, just chill around here. You can run a lot of fates in a very short period of time. Am I even going the right way? Yes. Resummon my pet. Just in case, I don't trust this junk monger. I do, but you know. Funny Mikote dance, funny dance. You dance funny dance too. Is that a reference to something? Because it sounds like it's a reference to something. I will dance funny dance for you. I should put the bathing suit on when I do this. Just for no reason whatsoever. Hello. I must have something to amuse me during these little jaunts back to civilization. I like this dude. Already, I've seen him for like 2 seconds and I like this dude. I kinda sorta did balk at the dancing, but whatever. You people, you Arcanist people and your calculation nonsense. Look at the size of that man's book. He's got a sweet book. He's got a sweet robe, too. You should put your notes in your book. That'd be a good idea. As an Arcanist, it was a simple matter to engineer vents. So it is. I've heard that before. He has a very short tail, too. He's gonna give me his book. My word, that is a very large book. It's worse than the one I have, but whatever. And the recording is doing that weird thing where the frame rate doesn't show up all the time again. I don't know why it does that, it's quite bizarre. Like right when there's no dialogue, it's not showing the recording again, whatever. Or wait, is that her? Oh, it's her grimoire? Is that what it is? I will know if you don't. This man and his dancing. This dude's like, what's going on here? He's got a sweet straw hat, though, gotta say. To the anchor yard in Limsa Luminsa. Hokey. Can I have your robe? I've had his gloves. I used to have his gloves, in fact. Swapped him out, though. So, dance for her at the anchor yard. Where is the anchor yard, actually? Oh, it's right next to the aft castle. Okay. We're just gonna teleport back anyway, but I just wanted to know where in the city it was. This is a relatively lengthy quest, considering all I've really done is dance for a bunch of things. Find some papers, dance for some other things. I kinda liked that quest. To be quite frank. I like the little, like the cookie crumb trail that I was led on. Frame rate in this area is garbage. It's because of all the people it renders. I wish there was some way to limit how many it renders, but it already does that. It's got a very weird prioritization system. And you'll see many people complain about it. Anyway, welcome to the summer fair. It's in Limsa Luminsa, right at the aft castle, and you can run over here to these people to gather your goods. You can talk to the captain, I believe, to learn about it. Actually, I never did. Let's see. Dire need of brave souls. Yeah, you have to go kill the bombard fate in Costa del Sol, and you get this stuff, and you can trade it in for, as you can see, many, many things. So, of course, you can also sell that stuff on the market, like I've been doing. And then have people, like, Muffin, buy it all off of you. All is well in the world. This way. This is actually a blacksmith tool. I need to grab some more crafting stuff to see what level 15 ability they have. I guess I could kind of explain why I'm leveling other crafting classes. You could still use cross-class abilities, and Leatherworker and Carpenter have two very useful abilities at 15. One of them is Waste Not, which is a 50% reduction in durability lost for the next 4 steps. And the other one is Ruination? Something along those lines. This is a cool view. Check out the view. We barely missed the sunset, which sucks, because this game has cool sunsets. But that one gives you... what it does is it removes the Inner Quiet ability, and it will replenish CP based upon how many times quality was increased. So it's a very useful ability to have. Oh, she's gone into her depressed mode. I will dance for you. Look, I dance for you. I don't know what's going on over there, but look at me, woman. You have met with our guildmaster. I have. What would happen if you say no? We shall hand over the grimoire. It's because he wishes to give you a new book. The leather binding of this recently crafted tome is uncracked, its pages still crisp. And it is once again a gift from the guildmaster. Well, really, he just had me dance for random stuff. Dance for the box, dance for the other dude, dance for you, dance for the sake of dancing. Does Maga? Who? Does Maga? Does Maga? Okay. Really, the entire purpose of this is just simply to unlock the level 30 quest and then unlock the ability to become a summoner, which I'm, as far as I'm assuming, is the level 30 quest, but I don't know. Maybe it's an item from the level 30 quest, I have no idea. This would obviously be the first time this has been an issue. We'll go this way. I think it might be slightly faster to head this way and then use the teleport over. I went the wrong way up the stairs. And then use the teleport to get to the Arcanist Guild. I love the decorations. They're just a bunch of bombs, by the way. And then they got little bombs on their heads. And look at them. They're so cute. Oh, they're bomb things. Bomb balloons, as they were. In fact, the fate you have to go do is about a bunch of bombs. Hence why it's called Bombard. In fact, I believe the enemies themselves are called Bombards. So... interesting to know, I suppose. It's actually a cool fate. And those decorations are actually from that fate, kind of, because there's little like hot air balloons or whatever sitting out there that are decorated like that. I would show you the fate, but, you know, there's a billion people there. It lags like crazy. Return to your training. What she means is become level 30, which you already are. I'm probably going to be taking... actually, those boots are better. I'll just take this. Nah, it's only one silver piece, though. 500 gil. I'll take the boots. I'll just straight up equip the boots right now. I may have better boots, actually. I just did shift I instead of whatever. So, let's see here. Where did I just... these. I just got those. Is there anything better? No. And those are actually ethereal. Interesting. Interesting! Bane. Spreads targets Bio, Bio 2, and Miasma to all nearby enemies. Really? And a book. A better book, actually. But no sign of... Those are all actually improvements. And 3 silver pieces is actually really good. Bane is what I'm most interested in. And it has a 15% chance that the duration will reset. That's actually really good. You have to be Aetherflow though. Hmm. No sign of the summoner gem, but who knows. Word of Dozmaga. Well, there you go. I still don't know how to pronounce that. Appears his merchant vessel is presently anchored off the coast of Bloodshore. Where the heck is Bloodshore? Her and her formulations and strategies and whatnot. Travel to Costa del Sol and deliver this set of directions to a fisherman by the name of Rylzirin? I don't know. Okay, guess what we're doing? Teleporting to Costa del Sol. At least now you can see Costa del Sol. We won't see the fate, probably, unless it just happens to be nearby when I'm there. It's not very far from the actual city itself, or the town itself. It's not a city. The village, as it were. I don't know if you count this as a town or village. Probably more a village. And we're actually running the opposite way of the fate. The fate's down here. That general direction. We, apparently, need to go way over here. How far over here are we going? Oh, right over here. Okay. There he is. You can also... There's a boss fate over there against a giant enemy crab called Cancer, of all things. Wait, this isn't him. What? What? That's not right at all. And you can actually get a minion, which I will show you, called Small Shell. These are actually enemies that you can see. At least they're modeled very similarly to enemies that you can fight near or in. What is this crap? There we go. What is it? Western Thonalon? North of Horizon? Where the watery area is? You don't really look like you have your hands full with fishing. You have a sweet rod, though. It looks kind of rifle-y. I like my rifle-y rods. Wait, what? You're to take one of me, herrings and deliver it to the cook. The cook where? Oh. Okay, I thought it was going to make me take it to the cook in Names of Lamenza. I was like, jeez, man. Can I not aggro something? Also, pro tip. If you say please res, or can I get a res, in the shout chat, type POS, P-O-S, with the little brackets around it. Little carrot brackets, or alligator brackets, or whatever you want to call them. Because that will actually automatically place your position. So, for instance, it'll put, what would it put, actually? I think it would put Bloodshore, and then 3229, to let people know the exact coordinates. It's actually quite useful. As you can see, someone asked for chords. If you just type POS, it'll automatically do it for you. That's not coordinates at all. There you go. Someone else did it. Apparently it'll just say Eastern Lenosia. I thought it would say sub-regions, but I guess not. You! Herring so fresh it still flaps its fins in one final desperate attempt to propel itself from your pack through the air and back into the sweet saltwater it once called home. I need to read those more often because they're quite good. I really do like the overall... There goes a fate party running off over there. The overall writing in this game is very good. Why does the... Wait, what? Why the master does enjoy a bite of broiled fish? Homemade eel pies. Take the pie to Master... Who? Gege Ruju? I would, quite frankly, rather scoff it down myself, but where is this guy at? He is right there. Okay. Most interesting. This is a very odd quest so far. Literally just ferrying items to people. Whoops-a-daisy. I think my mouse may have gone outside the window or something there, or I right-clicked on, like, one of those. One of my UI elements. Ew, well. There's some dancers in pink over here, and that guy cheering. I don't recall seeing those before, but who knows. Oh, if you haven't noticed as well, the chocobo still flaps with the Bahamut armor on. Or Behemoth armor, sorry, not Bahamut armor. That would be silly. Apparently something happened. What brings you to my, and I use this term, words that I can't pronounce, humble abode. I am. How commendable that you should research the delicacies that tickle my fancy before daring to intrude upon my most ponderous of ponderings. Speaking of ponderous, well, I was speaking of it. At least I have a hefty purse of gold persuading you to relinquish your claim on that pastry. What? But have you believe her homemade eel pie is far more delicious than Mother Mione's? Real realm famous handmade eel pie. Okay. Oh, they did vigil run with a pug. Nice. I've heard that's quite hard. That's some cleavage there. Just saying. One moment, if you will. I've been instructed by a Melvin's Gate assessor to hand over this message to whoever delivers an eel pie. This is all very suspicious and arduous. Kinda. Take the purse you receive and hand it to the dancer. Eel Gith. Who names these people? Okay. This is seriously convoluted. Just saying here. You could have just given me a bag of money and I could have just handed it to the dancer rather than this convoluted chain of events, but perhaps, mayhaps, perchance, you don't look like a dancer unless you're already home or something. This is like a test or something. Oh. I have a heavy purse, a leather purse filled to bursting with gil. I wish it was actually gil so I could have it. The leather satchel is from your Mikote friend, and the pario is from me. You deliver to Drogo, the warehouse foreman. Okay. Seriously, what is this quest? Where is this one? He's up there. He's not even in the town, is he? Oh, well, actually, yeah. He's not very far off of it, so I guess it's not really an issue. The crystals at night look so cool. They're very dim during the day. Oh, he's still in the town. I thought he was up on that little ledge over there. But at night, they're very shiny. It's really quite cool looking. Dude's tank bet's almost dead. Interesting. Let's see here. I have a thing for you. An odd leather statue. A colorful cotton undergarment worn for countless summers by the dancer. That is moderately disturbing. That is moderately disturbing. Take it to the Flying Shark and pour a cup for the sailors. What in the heck are we doing here? I'm very confused what this has to do with the old boat thing. Again, I could have just come over here and gotten everyone a drink if that was the original plan, but who freaking knows? There's the shark, by the way. If you don't know where it gets its name from, there's the shark. Hello. Well, I guess that's why these people are here with the dancers. They're actually part of the quest. Taste your wine, eh? Wine's so old, no one alive can remember when it was bottled. The cork appears to still be intact. It's a good start. The cork is still intact. Ah, this was the horribly convoluted chain of events that really convoluted, but whatever. I will agree to board the Morning Star. Don't mind my, you know, suspicious book and whatnot. Mrs. Dancer? Guess who the dancer is? I didn't know she was so good at dancing. Also, I was unaware she was willing to do that, but whatever. I'm just gonna run, see if I can get there. Without falling off would be a good step, considering it's right here. I think I could get there in the run time. The sprint thing. You do actually, chocobos are actually slightly faster, but it's very, very small amount. And again, they don't have the whole... Oh, it's actually way out here, isn't it? Nope, well, couldn't make it. Oh well. Costa del Sol, by the way, very beautiful sunsets. Everything in the game has very beautiful sunsets, just Costa del Sol is a much, you know, it's a good place for it. Nice little beach area, good view of where the sun sets over yonder. I think it's actually about that area right there where there's that little dip in the land. If your level is above 34, which it's not, I'm actually on level for this quest for once. Because I want to be a summoner. Gosh darned it. I don't know what that sound was. Oop. Check out those sweet water textures up close for no reason. Some eerie music. Captain will be pleased with this haul. Why am I not allowed to stare? Look at it! She's very sad about this. Oh, is that her belongings then? As I pull it out of nowhere. Hello. Look at the look I was giving him. You'd think he would have noticed, you know, or at least possibly heard, considering I'm standing right next to the dude, and he is in fact looking past us to know where the boat is going, but whatever. Where is she gonna pull her book from? Also, wouldn't he remember me, considering I've been here before? And her once she shows up, considering, you know, it's her. Oh, that was rapid de-robing there, jeez. So it's gonna be the two of us versus this dude again. Oi! Language, man, language! It is I who shall be teaching this day. Through applied strategy, eh? Uh-oh, what's she doing here? She's summoning a book? She already has a book, though. What's the point of summoning a book when she has a book? Or is this a special book? Is my pet here? My pet is here. What is her book doing? And this is a lot of dudes. I'm hoping you know what you're doing, woman. Because this is a lot of very angry men. Admittedly, they appear to be fairly weak. And she appears to be fairly strong, so at least there's that. Also, my sound's way too high. Everything's so loud. What is her book doing, exactly? And my carbuncle is being beaten to crap right now, so... I already got that, actually. Jesus. Oh my word, there's a lot of these dudes. I may need to actually summon... Oh no, she's going over there to aggro them. I was about to say, I may need to actually summon my... Topaz carbuncle. Hers is doing alright, but hers is horribly overleveled, so where did she just wander off to there? So those are down. I don't know what she's doing over here. I'm assuming if she dies, it's a bad day, but I'm also assuming she will heal. I should stop standing next to her when she gets AoE'd constantly. Woman, you're supposed to be doing things. Yeah, my pet's gonna die. There it goes. Let's run back here, and I don't know, I seriously don't know what this pet's doing. Vulnerability down. Oh, I walked. That was stupid. Amount of damage suffered from both physical and... Okay, so that's what that's doing. I need to heal. Should probably heal her as well. Although she has a lot of health, and she will heal herself, it seems. So I'm not entirely sure it's necessary. Yeah, heal nothing on her. Don't even try. Oh no, the book isn't doing vulnerability down, unless it's... I don't know. So we wanna kill this dude eventually? My pet's not doing anything for whatever reason. Alright. That could have gone better. I want that dude's ring. He's got a large ring. I've already killed like 20 people. How many people you got on this ship? I mean, numbers would be good too. You got another thing coming. He does have quite the large axe, just saying. Kill the ads first. You know the deal here. And something's already happening. I think she's already actually aggroed the dude. Well done, woman. I'm gonna put Miasma, Bio 2, Bio, and Arrow on these two, and that should be enough to get rid of them. Plus whatever damage the pets do. And there's one more ad, and then we'll start taking him down, assuming he doesn't spawn more people, which he probably does. I still don't know what her book is doing. But whatever. We have two Topaz Carbuncles, but mine takes a massive beating. Actually, hers is taking a massive beating. This dude hurts a lot. Let's see how much he does. Yeah, the dude hurts a lot. I kind of wish he would stop hurting quite so much, but hey. I should probably use lightning. I should have used lightning on him earlier, but whatever. This book must be do something, because she keeps running over here. As if to pull him into it or something. Ooh, that's... Yeah, let's not stand in front of the dude. He knows overpower! Albeit his overpower takes a while. Yeah, I skipped lightning again because I'm an idiot. Whatever. And you're dead. That wasn't too hard. In fact, that was relatively easy, quite frankly. Like, I had a 30-minute time limit. Limit. Like, it would take that long. She knows well. Yeah. He jumped into the water. I summoned yellow jackets? When did that occur? Also, are they swimming in the water outside the boat, or are they just in boats out there? Oh, he jumped onto a boat. What? Wait, what? Oh, well, whatever. Well done, I suppose. Hello. Some dramatic music there. I like your hat, man. Is he laughing? I can't tell. He wasn't making any noise. We'll go with a rage cry, how about that? You probably should take his weapon away from him, you know? I mean, I know he's shackled, but you could take his axe off his back. That'd be a good step. I mean, you know, if he rolls over on someone, I imagine that might hurt. That was a lecture? I wish to obtain summoner. It is time I sought out our guildmaster. I concur. See? I told you I concur. Is your guildmaster in the water? I hope he is, otherwise that's awkward. I'm gonna assume yes. Yep. Oh wait, no, someone's over there. You know, jumping onto a boat from a boat like this tall isn't really the best idea, so at some point she had to have gotten in the water. One of these days, Final Fantasy games will actually have, you know, wet clothes. Oh, look at that sunset. I wonder if that was just lucky timing. Actually, that's a sunrise, isn't it? I don't know what time it is on the server. I wonder if that's scripted or if that's just lucky timing. What is Eorzea time? It's 3:09 a.m. so I'm gonna go with that was scripting. Because the sun doesn't rise at 3 a.m. Yeah, it's raining. Battle Cat? Battle Cat and this man are just chilling over here, I guess. And we need to actually go back to the Arcanist Guild, so... let's just go ahead and teleport, because I don't want to run all the way back. That's a long run. May not even get summoner today. I might have to record a little chunk tomorrow at some point. I don't know, tomorrow night or something. So that I can get summoner, because it doesn't look like that this quest is going to give it to me. This quest may unlock another quest that I can do. Or I'm just missing something? I don't know. I don't know how this works, obviously. Quite clearly, I have no idea what I'm talking about, but from what I know, you need 30 in Arcanist and 15 in Thaumaturge, and that will allow you to unlock Summoner via some quest from the Guildmaster in the Arcanist Guild. Who knows? You may have the satchel. Yes. So this is just whatever what's-her-name didn't take on the boat. I'm glad to know that she has finally freed herself to pursue her heart's desire. You're welcome. I'm not sure those two in the same room would actually have any, you know, use. But whatever, they'll have their noses buried in books, we'll roll with that. A new technique! This will actually be very useful, and I will take... I can't actually wear any of these, but I'll take the leggings. I can use that book, though. Although, if from the icon, it looks very similar to the book I already have. Oop! Bane has been learned! This is a joyous day, and I will put Bane right there. We'll roll with that. I actually already have another quest. And there is a locked quest over there with the guild receptionist, so I'm very curious about what's going on here. Let's check. What was I going to check? Right, equipment. Because I have some leggings and a book. God knows where these leggings are. I've got too much crap here. I don't remember what they look like either. I have to do a quick skim through here, I guess, until we find them. Oh no, right, I can't wear them, that's right. I can use the book, though. Which has intelligence, accuracy, and vitality. Intelligence and determination. I'll run with that book. It's an identical book. Let's investigate the guildmaster here. Aha! There it is, right there. Soul of the Summoner. And of course, summon three, which, you know, ability of a summoner. You know what? Yeah. We will investigate this quest tonight and see just how long it is. How long I guess it is. Hopefully it's not like a 30-minute run or something silly. The Sons of Saint Connach, something along those lines. They have asked for you by name. It appears that the research the Sons are currently conducting would benefit from the assistance of an Arcanist. A researcher by the name of Yemrita at Apkulu Falls in the nation of Gridania. Where? Good lord. Where is that at? Old Gridania. Closest is probably the Whistling Mire. We'll go with the Whistling Mire. We will see just how much work this is, shall we? It's 30 minutes, I'm going to be moderately sad, because then it'll be really late and I'll be sitting here talking into a sock. With a very dry throat, because I don't have anything to drink. I checked my cup there. Nothing to drink, been talking a long time today too. Just straight up may not stream tomorrow, because I got a... oops. Minor headache. And I'll have a sore throat if I keep going too much longer here. But I'm curious. It's the amphitheater one. Nope. 'Twas not logged off. This is usually when I'd sit here and screw around with the chat, so. Or the free company and talk to everyone. It's that time of day, you know, everyone's winding down. I'm usually just doing botany or something, watching the Northern Lions Super Show. Or YouTube videos, usually YouTube videos. I like the signs, by the way. I don't know if you guys have ever noticed the signs, but the signs don't actually say anything on them, the ones you're supposed to be able to use. It's glorious. Master of the Rolls. This is an interesting little gathering of people over here. That's a cool area back there as well. I like that. I am Arania Telrath. Ours is a Charlean order that seeks the lost knowledge of the Elegant Empire. So this would, I'm assuming this would be the people I get summoner quest chains from? I don't know. I'm assuming Arcanist and summoner quest chains can be different. They very well may not be. One monumental obstacle, you say? One must first defeat a primal and capture its etheric essence. The only one who can boast such a daunting achievement under her belt may even begin... okay. That would be me. Come to me in the west, Byregot's Strike in southern Tonalon. Must I go all over the world for you, woman? For real. Actually, I should quickly check, see if I have a close summon or a teleport to it. Oh, down there? I do have a close teleport to it. The Forgotten Springs. It'll be expensive, but, you know, whatever. 500 gil, I'll survive. Yeah, as a gathering class, 300,000 experience? Ooh. Bad day. It's already bad just at level 30, or yeah, I think I'm not even level 30 actually. Just getting to level 30 is ridiculous. Anyway, welcome to the actual desert. I've actually been here in a recording, but welcome to the actual desert. A lot of people have issues running this place at day because of the weird effect they've got going on. But, you know. I seem to do alright every time I've been out here, but I'm usually not out here during the day, so... We'll see how long we're out here and just how bright it becomes, I suppose. Plus there's sandworms here. Everyone likes sandworms, except for the people who don't like sandworms. What, pray tell, are we doing out here, madam? According to the records we discovered, recovered, perform these rites in a land in which the naturally dominant element matched the aspect of the avatar they wished to call forth. Well, I guess we could, like, stand in a forest fire or something. And this is going to be the gem that I desire? I would like this gem. A vibrant current of energy transforming into living fire. Okay. Be aware, however, that this nascent, I don't know how to pronounce that word, entity will appear before you unbound and hostile. Okay. Glad it's gonna throw me into an instance, because the friggin' sandworms would undoubtedly screw me over here. These sandworms hurt. They hit like a truck, man. At least last time I was out here, but then again I was underleveled last time I was out here, so... That is quite the gem you have given me there. It's also very glowy. Hello? You're very angry, sir. I'm gonna have my pet sick him. Sick him, pet. That's actually quite a lot larger than the one I can get sick. Oh, she's actually gonna help me, is she? Oh, that's gonna make this drastically easier. I thought I was gonna have to do this solo. Ooh, he hurts a lot. Look at the damage he's doing to the freaking pet there. Actually gonna sustain the pet. Just quite frankly, because I don't want that damage hitting me, so... I'm actually gonna pull aggro if I keep hitting this dude. Yep, there it goes. We're gonna wait a bit. A flame shiver. Stone skin. She has stone skin. She's actually a conjurer, isn't she? Yes, she is. If the pet keeps that dude's bit, this is like a solo boss fight here. Kill the adds! Okay. Always focus the adds down, then. I'm assuming she'll heal my pet. Should the... need rise? I'm unsure though. She appears to be healing. Oh no, she's just casting magic on that thing. Oof. A crimson nail? Okay. This is literally like a mini Ifrit fight. I wonder if he'll actually use like a special ability or something. These things take a lot of damage. Just saying, these things take a lot of damage, and I wish they didn't. Oh sure, when you hit it, it dies instantly. Can I bio these? I doubt it. Also, is it healing? It appears that Ifrit may be healing from these spikes. And you, in fact, can't bio the spikes, so... The nails, as they were. The spikes in Ifrit's fight, but whatever. So it doesn't look like he will use an ability, it looks like these are just very slowly healing him, maybe buffing him. Oh, never mind. I was mistaken. As it turns out, he'll eventually just kill you. Well. Hold on, let me see if someone res. The timing on that, man. I literally just popped out of that duty and that person ran across just happened to be someone who could res me. Oh, it's someone actually doing the same quest as well. Let's take the other pet. And see how this goes. Probably gonna have to wait down this weakness timer. At the very least, I'll have to wait for my MP and stuff to restore here. So as it turns out, it is in fact very similar to the Ifrit fight in the fact that it'll just straight up kill you if you take too long. Good to know. When does this thing actually start counting in seconds? Does it ever start counting in seconds? Because, you know, it's been quite a while since that thing said 1 minute. Yeah, whatever. I think it still counts down, actually, while I'm in these dialogues or scenes or whatever as well, so. We should be all right. Although, with my pet... do I want the tanking pet? It keeps him off of me, but it also lowers my DPS by quite a lot if I have the pet just sitting there worrying about aggro. We'll see how this goes. I very well may die again, who knows. I should have set my spawn point, but whatever. Wait, we'll wait for her to engage here in a moment. Although she's not going to keep aggro for crap, so... Yeah, he instantly swapped to me. She will use stone skin on me, though. Oh, it hurts so much. No, not that. Don't revive him. That's a very silly thing to do. Now, the goal here, in theory... is to worry about the adds. And just kind of damage over time this dude down. I think I'm out of range on that. I was. And my weakness is gone, finally. Actually, she looks like she handles the adds. This dude hits hard. Yeah, I'm not sure I can actually do this without the tanking pet. We'll see. I don't think I can, but we'll see. Because he's going to be hitting me while I'm hitting the spikes is the main issue here. I think he calls the spikes at about half health. And she's handling the adds well enough. Hit the spikes, buddy. Hit the spikes. Basically, just want to focus down the spikes as quickly as possible. She's helping with the spikes as well, so... quickly heal. And the DPS on this guy is much higher than the Topaz one. Plus it's ranged, you know? Doesn't have to run around. I like how it says he invokes an infernal nail. Hit that one. Hit it quickly! He appears to have simply stopped attacking outright. Which, you know, fine by me. If I don't have to tank him, that's probably the best thing that could happen. Now is the time to press your attack indeed. He appears to be literally stuck. Well, now he's over there. Well done, pet. You ruined everything. Let's get some MP back real quick. I would use, what is this? Bane. But it's only a 15% chance to extend the duration of those, so... I'll just, quite frankly, wait for it to run out. In fact, I don't even think I need to reset all of these, but I'm gonna try to do it anyway. Nah, we don't need to. He appears to literally just... he stopped attacking. I'm not sure why. He straight up killed me the first time and then just gave up halfway through this time. Whatever. Person testing out their new summon, I suppose. The Fireborn Aegi has submitted to your will. Yeah, it's a bunch of people finishing the quest, testing summons, it looks like. Or trying again, who knows. That's actually the person that revived me, isn't it? Alright, we have to return to the person in the falls, so... back to New Gridania. Yeah, why not? It's just a bunch of Arcanists out there. Periodically coming back out dead. That's probably a thing that happens to a lot of people the first time in that or the Ifrit fight, actually. If you don't know anything about the Ifrit fight and you're too slow about the spikes, you'll just straight up die. So, that's always a thing, I suppose. Amphitheater. That's what it was. I probably could have done it the first time if I had told my pet to attack the spikes. But I wasn't thinking all too clearly. I was going with the keep the pet on the Ifrit dude, mini Ifrit, so I didn't have to worry about healing and just hit the spikes myself. But as it turns out, that wasn't really necessary, because his AI derped out. That may have been intentional, it may not have been, I have literally no idea. We're gonna roll with it was, and he just stops attacking when the spikes are dead, I don't know. Be known as Ifrit Eggy, where Eggy translates approximately to pure or of the essence of. In short, you have tamed a willful manifestation of Ifrit's raging fires. We have tamed a mini Ifrit. So this is a DPS summon, from what I'm aware of. I could be mistaken, but this is basically a replacement for your other two summons in their entirety, but from what I'm aware of, its main purpose is DPS. I don't know about the other two that you can obtain. I have a suspicion Titan is tank, and the Garuda one is, or whatever the other one is kind of a supportish one. I don't know. Top of the Lord of Crags, and we may progress to the next stage of our historic research. Next summoner quest. Yep, there's separate summoner quests. Okay, well. We have Soul of the Summoner and Summon 3, and we'll get a fancy little cutscene for Summon 3 here in a moment. Summoner unlocked. Slightly off-center, or all of my UI is slightly off-center. It's probably all my UI is slightly off-center, but whatever. Yay! So let us equip our soul. So we are now a summoner, and my entire UI is now changed. Is there going to be a separate... That's not at all what I wanted to actually do. Put that back on. Do I need to make a separate one for summoner? I do. Okay. Oh, everything's all sorts of screwed up. I'll have to fix all of this on my own time, but in the meantime, we have a summoner now. Or I am a summoner now. And say hello to our little Ifrit Eggy buddy. Look at him, he's so cute. He's got no legs. And that guy's gonna try it out too. We're like summon buddies. So there you go. Me and Nerathun have obtained our new Ifrit toy, and he's gonna sit there and look at it too. This is what people do, I've watched it all the time. They'll get closer looks at it and spin the camera around and stuff. But that's it, and I'll clap for this guy. And I will see you guys next time. Thanks for watching. See you then.